A long time ago, I posted this YouTube video, and in the last few days, it gains over 1,300 views, and due to a popular demand, today I'll be making a tutorial on it. But before we start, it's important for you to know that I'll be using the same video and just making a voiceover tutorial just as I used to do. And you guys know it already, but this design file is already available on the Figma community file. The link is in the YouTube community post. So as you know, I always like to start with a personalized navigation bar. Now grab your spiderweb image and use the icon's 8 background remover to get rid of the well background. Once you've done that, add it to the frame, bellow the nav bar. And add a linear fill to it. Its opacity should be around 20%. You want to take the darkest end and put it close to the middle of the frame and the brightest side on the exterior. You can play with the setting as you like it. Once you are done, copy it and flip it vertically using Shift plus H. Add a circle in the middle. Put it in red and use the glow plugin on it. Now add your image and resize it. Place your text below the image. Copy it and place the copy over the image. Delete its fill and add an inside stroke. Now you can finish designing the page. There, I'm just using an odd technique to create tabs. Basically, you create a text, you are making a tab selection, and you round the frame, and you center the text. Create a button and use the Iconify plugin to create a down arrow. Create a new frame and copy your background. Create a red rectangle at the top and draw a white line in its middle. Change its stroke style to dash. Group them and keep designing your page. When you're done, make a copy of the to page and start changing a few things. Remove this image background using the icon's 8 plugin. Change the image and for that double click on it and hit the change image button. Resize it. Next, change the circle and its glow color. And use the color overlay plugin to switch its color from black to yellow. Now you want to make the same thing you did for the web image. Keep make change on the pages. Copy the first pages and start dragging the elements out, and make sure you always put their opacity to zero and scale down the circles. Now, add the second pages to the main frame and make sure their x-axis is 0 and their y-axis is 1080. Now copy them once again and select some elements of the first page, such as the names of the cast, the navigation bar, the tags, and drag them up till they are out of the frame, for the others dragging them up a little bit. Select the second page and drag it in until it covers about a half of the frame. Do as I do and select the movie name, the circle in the image, and slide them so you can still see them on the frame, and put the image above the second frame. You want to do the same thing for the Black Panther page. Now got to prototype and link the first two page with an after delay and copy my setting. Link the arrow width the first page with these settings. And link the last two page with a on drag with those settings. And there you go. Enjoy.
Bye.